Assalamu alaikum warahmatullahi ta'ala wabarakatuh. Welcome on Hadith Disciples, YouTubers and viewers upon the Sunnah Nathar to another exclusive episode of FMF 5 Minutes of Faida. Bismillah, alhamdulillah, wa salatu wa salamu ala rasulillahi amma ba'd. The great tabi'i, the alim al-jaleel, Imam al-Hasan al-Basri rahimahullah ta'ala, is narrated that he once said, رُوِيَ عَنْ بَعْضُ الصَّالِحِينَ أَنُّهُ قَالَ أَفْضَلُ الزُّهْدِ إِخْفَاءُ الزُّهْدِ كان يقول الحسن رحمه الله تعالى روي عن بعض الصالحين أنه قال أفضل الزهد إخفاء الزهد. الحسن البصري رحمه الله, he used to say that there were righteous people who came before us who used to say. There were صالحين, righteous men and women from the Sahaba and from the Tabi'een who are older than Hasan al-Basri, and they would say that the best zuhd is hiding zuhd. The best concept or the best practice of the concept of abstinence from the worldly life and looking down upon the worldly life and not being deceived and duped and tricked by the worldly life and amassing possessions, fighting for possessions, lying, stealing, cheating, conniving to gain riches and status and authority and things like this. The best practice of zuhd is not to manifest it, it's to show it. Now what does this statement mean? What do we get from it? How do we benefit from it? And why did Hasan al-Basri rahimahullah ta'ala quote the Salaf before him? And Hasan was from the Salaf. What's meant by this? First and foremost is, he says, afdhal al-zuhd, that the best zuhd, i.e. is that zuhd is of different levels. There's different levels of zuhd. And they all aren't obligatory. All of them aren't mandatory. All of them aren't necessarily recommended for certain people. Certain people in certain positions with certain status and certain authority don't necessarily have to practice all types of zuhd. And they shouldn't, such as a leader, such as a king, such as someone who has to be a representative of the Muslims. He's the head of the delegation of the Muslims, etc. And then there are other levels of zuhd that are obligatory, that every single Muslim must know about and must practice. And there are other levels of zuhd which are recommended and preferred for all Muslims. And we know that the Quran al-Kareem is full of the concept of a zuhd. And Allah Azza wa Jal, He tells us in so many different ayat about the worldly life, وَضْرِبَ لَهُمْ مَثَلًا حَيَاتِ الدُّنْيَا, and make for them Muhammad sallallahu alayhi wa sallam the parable, the similitude of the worldly life. And Allah, He talks about that the worldly life is play and amusement, وَتَكَثْرٌ, and the people stacking up material possessions, money, wealth, and children, and things like this. This is what the Quran is full of. And the hadith of the Prophet والسلام, that tells us about the worldly life and warns us against the worldly life and not being tricked and deceived and losing our religion for Yabiru Dinahu, the man will wake up as a believer and go to sleep as a kafir, or vice versa, waliyadu billah, and he will sell his deen, Yabiru Dinahu, bi'aradhi min ad-dunya, because of some type of worldly possession. And oftentimes, the Prophet, he scorns and he disdains lawful things in the worldly life, things that are permissible to have. Those who migrate for Allah and His Messenger, then their migration will be for Allah and His Messenger. And those whose migration is for dunya, or a woman to marry, then he's only migrating to whatever he's migrating towards. And he never mentioned it for Allah and His Messenger a second time. So the Quran and Sunnah are full of ample countless ayat and hadith about the concept of zuhd, its ruling, its levels, etc. But many people, they have a misunderstanding of zuhd. They have an improper conceptualization of zuhd. And from that is what Hasan al-Basri rahimahullah ta'ala says, what some of the righteous people used to say, is that sometimes the best zuhd is ikhfa' al-zuhd, is not showing the people. And you don't always have to make a parade for your zuhd and things that you have to do. Sometimes it's best to hide something that you're doing. Sometimes it's best to put on a show for people to think that you're normal and think that everything's basic, but all along is best what's inside of your household, the things that you may not have, the things that you may not eat, the things that you may not drink, how you may live from week to week, day to day. Everyone doesn't have to know that. So sometimes the best zuhd is not the zuhd which is publicized. And obvious, when you publicize the zuhd, you may have a different intention. People may praise you. People may applaud you. People may clap their hands and walk behind you and clap and cheer and parade behind you. And that's not also, that's not always necessarily a good thing. So he says that these righteous people, they used to say, afdhal az-zuhdi ikhfa' az-zuhd. And we all know the kalam of the Salaf al-Salih regarding the worldly life, and his dispraise is abundant.